Hey everybody, what's up? Greg Hamilton here, and as you can see, we're not in the ring, and I'm not in my suit, and this is my loft. We're in downtown Cincinnati, and you know, a lot of people that I work with like to share their hobbies when they're at home. For me, when I'm home, I love to spend time in the kitchen, so that's what we want to do today. I've got some ingredients laid out right here, which we'll get to, but on the menu today, some Asian-inspired short ribs, which are in the sous vide right now. This is all part of the marinade. We're also gonna do some corn, but we're gonna do it a little bit different. We're gonna do it on the grill, so you get that char, but then a chipotle-lime crema on top, which is one of my favorite things to do. Super, super easy, guys. And then just for a snack, some shishito peppers, which we're gonna also do on the grill with some chili flakes. So listen, I'm not a chef. This is just a hobby for me, but it's one of my passions, one of my favorite things to do. And it's super easy. Cooking does not have to be overwhelming or difficult. And we're gonna go through all of that today on Greg Hamilton's WWEats. The corn is peeled, as you can see, but just wanna melt a little bit of butter in the microwave. Super, super low heat, just so it melts but doesn't break. But you wanna keep this husk on because we're gonna put these on the grill, and that's gonna help seal in a lot of the moisture and also sort of protect it if it gets over, you know, a high flame or something like that. But we still want some char. So, corn prepped, next is gonna be the chipotle lime crema. This is just an awesome crema from a local mercado that I found. This stuff is fantastic, man. Their crema is great. So this is gonna be the base of the chipotle lime crema. These are great. So these are chipotles, but they're in an adobo sauce. All you need from this is the adobo sauce. It's already so spicy. You can chop up the chipotles if you want to and put them in there, but I don't think you're gonna want to. And listen, it does not take much. The ratio on this, maybe 4 parts crema to 1 part adobo sauce, because it's pretty spicy. You want some of that lime juice in there. That acid's really gonna cut some of that heat and pair well with the crema as well. Rough chop some cilantro. Some people aren't crazy about cilantro. For some reason, I guess some people taste soap when they eat cilantro. I don't, I think it's great. Do it. A little pepper isn't gonna hurt. And then just whisk. If you've ever been to, you know, like a Japanese restaurant or an Asian restaurant, sometimes in the menu you'll see blistered shishito peppers with different flavors. They're so easy. This is how easy this is. We're gonna put some oil in there. What do you wanna season them with? Some people just like salt and pepper. Some people just like them plain. I like to use these Korean chili flakes. These are so tasty. And then just toss them, just to get a nice coating on all the peppers. So this is our sous vide, or water bath immersion circulator. And I know it sounds fancy, but it's not. Here's what it is. This basically keeps water circulating at a perfect temperature. So right now, for example, we've got our Asian short ribs in there with all of those ingredients. I'm talking about the ginger, the pear, the pepper, the brown sugar, and all of that's vac sealed in with those short ribs, right? So it's keeping that vac seal tight in there and imparting all of that flavor into the ribs. Okay. Oh my God, it smells so good. And I mean, these are like perfect top to bottom, medium rare. We just need to finish them on the grill and crisp up that fat. So we have all of this reserve liquid in the bag, and some of that is from the sauces we use, but a lot of it also is from some of the fat that rendered off of those short ribs. That's gonna make a really, really beautiful and rich sauce once we reduce that down, get some of that water to boil out. So it's gonna take like, as you can see here, just a pan, and then strain this liquid. Wait, I don't know if I mentioned this earlier. This cut, like when a short rib is cut this way, that's called flanken style. So if you wanna get some of these, go to your butcher, just tell them you want short ribs flanken style. This is just, I don't know, I prefer this. Oh, it smells so good. All right, it's finally time to go start the fire on the grill. I know it's what you've been waiting for. But before we head out there, one thing that I did, as you noticed, we're gonna get this started now. This is gonna be that sort of reduction sauce, that drizzle over the meat, which is gonna be the very last step when we plate it. But while this is going, now we're gonna go set up the grill. Let's go plate. Okay, so we are going to let the meat rest, and while we're doing that, we're gonna start the preparation. We'll start with the corn and the peppers. There you have it, man, we're done. Look at this, our beautiful Asian short ribs right there that they smell amazing. Can't wait to dig into those. The corn came out great, you know, that the char from the husk, I think, actually helped with that chipotle lime crema, and then that fresh cotija cheese on top, and then some fresh cilantro, and then the blistered shishito peppers. At the end, I just drizzled it with a little bit of olive oil and some extra Korean chili flakes, but I think it's time to dig in. Oh, look at that color. Can you get in there? Look at that perfect medium rare from the sous vide. Mm. Show's over. Y'all can go home now. That is perfect. I mean, I love medium rare personally. I mean, that's great. And that, man, the crust and the char on that. And then I'm telling you, that pan sauce makes it. So we probably have like sauce all over my face, I don't care. Listen, in the comments below, tell me what you wanna see us cook next. I mean, it's endless. We can do anything you want. It can be on the grill, it can be inside, maybe some flatbreads. We can do a homemade tomato sauce, margarita style, but I wanna know what you wanna see us make next. So thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time, and I've got a lot to eat right now, because, yeah.